Welcome to Wednesday. It's the 25th day of January 2023, your Day Weather Podcast, brought to you by Cowboy State Daily. Check them out at cowboystatedaily.com and YDOT. Remember, when there's ice and snow, take it slow. Well, we have a lot happening. First of all, we're going to see chilly conditions. The chilly temperatures we've had all week will persist, but now we're throwing in a couple of wrinkles. There's a weather system that's going to be coming south out of Montana through Wyoming and into Colorado today, producing occasional snow showers and flurries for many areas. Again, this is not a big weather maker, but in the high country, across some of the plains, especially the northern areas, you're going to see light snow and flurry activity at times, and temperatures will remain cold. And then as we start to see this push of Arctic air coming out of Canada, the winds are going to be picking up, and we're going to have some strong winds, especially along I-80 and I-25 on Thursday, and that's going to cause blowing snow with the snow showers and the strong winds. There's going to be some travel problems there. Then the Arctic air pushes in. Now, the last Arctic blast, many of you will remember, it came in a blink of an eye, where temperatures fell extremely quickly and by a lot. This Arctic air mass is not going to come in gangbusters like the last one did, kind of oozing in, but when they ooze in, they tend to stay around a little bit longer, and we'll probably have at least three nights in a row of sub-zero temperatures in the region. Some of you, it'll be four or five nights. So do be ready for that, sub-zero temperatures and sub-zero wind chills. And we're going to also have what's called overrunning snowfall over the Arctic air. And you'll say, well, what is overrunning snowfall? We'll talk about that later on in the podcast. When you get these big Arctic air masses coming in, if you have a little bit of a right setup, you get what's called overrunning snow, as the Arctic air is overrun by Pacific air. And the cold will continue to spread across south and east across the rest of the United States. Today's satellite imagery continues to show the flow of the air. Look how much different it was than just a couple of weeks ago, because the air's got to go around that big high-pressure ridge that's off the west coast. But that northerly flow up here, you can see these clouds are headed down south into the Rockies. And this is what will be causing the occasional snow showers and flurries and continue to pump in the cold air. And there you can see it on the 500 millibar chart, how big and robust that high-pressure ridge is and how the turning of the jet stream flow is producing a lot of winter weather across the U.S. This low right here in the Midwest is going to be a big weather maker. Look at the advisories, the pink and the purple here, showing a lot of winter weather in the Midwest, parts of the Great Lakes and the Northeast. So travel in these areas today will be impacted by moderate, sometimes heavy snow in those areas. And look at down how far south the snow's getting into Oklahoma and Arkansas here. We have winter weather advisories for parts of Montana and northeastern Wyoming into the Black Hills as this wave comes south out of the region today. Then as we get into tomorrow, into Friday, we continue to see a coalescing of that low, that vortex of cold over Hudson Bay here. You can see how round it is. It's just a pocket, a very, very large pocket of Arctic air. These systems right here drag in the cold air. So as we get into Friday and Friday night, temperatures begin to plunge, and the low behind it is going to drag in the coldest of the air as we get into the weekend and early next week. So you can see that right there. And notice how far back to the southwest there's a push of Arctic air, as well as to the south here. So cold air is going to spill over the Continental Divide, even into the Pacific Northwest. And then we're going to set up that overrunning situation, which we'll talk about here in a minute. I want to show you the evolution of the Arctic air as it heads south. So this is 5 a.m. Saturday, and all of these slides I'm going to show you are for 5 a.m. the following day. So you can see the cold air poised up there along the U.S.-Canadian border, moving into Montana, North Dakota. So that's Saturday morning. Sunday morning, you can see it's going right down the Front Range of Colorado, plunging into the Plain States, and then the deeper cold air getting stacked up over Montana. And then by Sunday, wow, look how much colder it is. This is by Monday, and this is by Tuesday, this is by Wednesday. So you can see that you're looking at the progression of that cold air heading south into the region. So be ready for the cold. And if you look at the temperatures, let's see what these temperatures are going to do. So this is for Sunday morning. So you can see the sub-zero temperatures across Montana, the Dakotas going into central and northern Wyoming, single digits pushing in elsewhere. So Sunday morning, Monday morning, We have sub-zero temperatures to the I-70 corridor, temperatures approaching 30 below zero in parts of Montana. Tuesday morning, very cold air. We're down to 13 below in Denver, sub-zero temperatures elsewhere. You can see that the Colorado Continental Divide is backing up and maybe keeping that cold air at bay for a little bit. But this is why we're going to have what's called overrunning set up, is that Arctic air, the deep Arctic air at least, is not going to be able to spill over the divide into the western slope, at least initially. This is Wednesday morning. There you can see the sub-zero temperatures maybe spilling over the divide a little bit further. Look at temperatures in northern Arizona getting down into the single digits there. Single digits in parts of New Mexico. And we've got a blue norther headed down into Texas. So what will happen is very cold temperatures, very cold wind chills. Speaking of wind chills, these are the wind chills by Monday morning. So we're talking about dangerously cold temperatures. Now, this is the snowfall that's going to happen between now and Friday. So between today and Friday, northwest flow will be producing snow in the high country, the gray areas, the lighter blue areas, lighter snow amounts, and some light accumulations and snow showers and flurries at times, but at least on the plains, not much. The exception is the I-90 corridor here. It's going to kind of get picked on in this pattern, seeing accumulating snows with this first initial wave of winter weather here over the next 48 hours or so. Then, as we take a closer look at what will develop with what we call this overrunning situation, this is by 5 a.m. Monday, and you can see these temperature anomalies. These are not temperatures. These are the deviations from the 30-year average. So you're talking about some very cold temperatures. But I want you to notice the contrast here between what's west of the divide, the orange colors here, where it's actually showing temperatures a little bit above average by Monday morning. But east of the divide, east of the mountain ranges, you've got the very cold air stacked up here. This sets up to what we call an overrunning situation. So this is a very idealized setup graphic that I've put here, but here are the mountains. Let's call this the mountains of the Front Range, wherever you want to call the Front Range areas of the Rockies. So you're out here, this would be the plains. Then what we've got here are the high country. So this would be the western slope. This would be areas east of the mountains right here to kind of give you a reference. So what will happen is the Arctic air pushes south into the area. Then you get the Arctic air that gets pushed up against the Front Range. Cold air is more dense. It's like water. It always goes to the lowest point of gravity. So that Arctic air gets pushed up against the divide, but it's not terribly deep, at least not deep enough to get over the mountains yet. And then that Arctic air west of the divide doesn't get there, but what is west of the divide with this green arrow is milder air, milder Pacific air, which actually has higher water content than this Arctic air here. So what will happen is this mild Pacific air comes over the divide and goes up over and on top of the Arctic air. And when that happens, the difference in the air masses, the warmer Pacific air, which is also more moist, collides with the Arctic air on the other side, and it's a great way to produce snowfall. And that's exactly what we see right here. You can see we talked about those sub-zero temperatures getting down to about I-70. So along and north of this line, a lot of the snow that you're seeing east of the divide, when you go along and east of the divide here, is going to be because of that overrunning situation here between now and into Wednesday. So as we get into Sunday, really starting Saturday up into Montana and northern Wyoming, Saturday, then Saturday night, Sunday, into Monday and Tuesday, overrunning snow along and east of the divide will take place. Heaviest up here in this band, but also we're going to see a situation where the mountains are going to be getting a lot more snow as well. Have yourself a great Wednesday. Get ready for the cold. We'll see you tomorrow.